Having learned to sail on smallish boats over the last 2 years, I wanted to know what it's like on a larger ship, so I decided to join the three-mast schooner Albert Johannes on her transfer from Rostock in Germany to Harlingen in the Netherlands. Because the forecast talked of bad weather in the North Sea on the weekend, we started on Wednesday evening rather than Thursday morning. By 9 PM we had already motored past Warnemünde into the Baltic Sea. Since it was dark and the wind would not be in our favor, we didn't set any sails on this leg of the trip. This first night gave us a clear sky with a billion stars all around, as the song goes, and the next morning we had a beautiful sunrise in the Bay of Kiel. By 9 AM we had passed into the Kieler Förde, and an hour later we were in the locks at Holtenau, about to enter the Kiel Canal. We had cleared the locks by 10:30 and were on the second leg of the trip, the 95 kilometers to Brunsbüttel and the North Sea. The first part of our trip through the canal was eerily lonely. It was only after we had stopped for ice cream in Rendsburg, about a third of the way in, that we started encountering more and larger ships. At 6:30 in the evening, we docked before the locks in Brunsbüttel and turned off the engine for the first time in 22 hours. We continued on at 5 AM Friday morning because we wished to sail on the morning tide to follow the mouth of the river Elbe into the North Sea. The outgoing tide off but doubled our speed over ground, and thus the sunrise found us just past Cuxhaven. The water flowing out gave the buoys a wake one would expect from moving ships, not from stationary objects. After breakfast, we finally raised three of our sails and set course for Terschelling, where we planned to dock and wait out the strong winds that were now scheduled to come out of the English Channel on Saturday afternoon. Sailing on a beam or even broad reach, Albert Johannes yielded a lot less than the only other sailor we saw on our way, even after we set two more sails later on. Of course, I suspect being at least 3 or 4 times their size didn't hurt either. By noon we were crossing the anchorage Neue Weser, and we passengers were added to the watch rotation, on a voluntary basis of course. I volunteered for the 12:00 to 4:00 watch and was relieved just after the weather got rainy. By the time midnight rolled around and I was on watch again, the rain had been replaced by light fog and the occasional drizzle. The wind had turned more southerly and we had to close all the sails at 2 a.m. At least it wasn't a boring shift. To make up for it, I got up somewhat later on Saturday than the days before. There wasn't much of a sunrise anyways. We passed Terschelling a good ways before we went about, then sailed back to come at the island from the south. That was the only time the ship was slightly temperamental, with beginnings of the forecast stronger winds and the waves coming directly from the side. Once we passed between Terschelling and Vlieland, the waves calmed down, and soon we lowered the remaining sails and motored into West Terschelling, a cute Frisian town. The afternoon was then spent on land, on shore leave, you could say. The strong winds seemed ideal for kites, both for kite surfing and just flying them. Sunday morning saw us leaving Terschelling near low water. The railing had been a little higher than the pier when we docked. It was time for the short hop from Terschelling to Harlingen. Short compared to the previous days at least, taking only 3.5 hours. There still was a bit of wind and a few waves that splashed up on deck between the hull and the lee boards, but overall the weather looked worse than it ended up being. We docked just across from a lightship and a whale figurine that regularly blew out water. Afterwards, we had another afternoon of shore leave, taking a trip through Harlingen. The end of the day and the trip was watching the sunset from the southern moon. After one last night aboard the ship, it was time to say goodbye to the crew, the ship, and the city, and I went back home.